happening. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up guys, Craft Farms here, and welcome back to another video. Finally back for you guys, so I'm recording this on Wednesday, and this is going out on Monday. So nothing's changed from the last video. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna get everything fired up, get rolling again here. I haven't gotten around to fixing beans and oats yet. I will get to that soon, hopefully. But yeah, we still have a little bit yet before we're ready for those anyways, so all is good. Shouldn't be too much longer, and we'll be ready to start playing on my map, hopefully. I'm hoping it won't be too much longer. Oh, I missed a bunch of sunflowers. At the rate that we're filling, every sunflower helps. This is not yielding the greatest. So I'm thinking I'm just going to use, like, a lot of the equipment that we're using here is what I'm going to use for starting equipment on my map. Like, we'll be using that truck, this combine, the headers that we're using. We'll be using a different drill than what we're using, and a different corn planter, but we'll be using similar tractors, a very similar lineup to what we have here, except we'll also be using an older pickup, and we won't have a fuel tank, like a fuel trailer, or anything, or, you know, anything like that. But, yeah, I'm not gonna do this starting pack like I was planning. Just decided I wasn't going to. Holy crap, really? That's stupid. Okay, we are going to use GPS here because this is ridiculous. I don't get it. I even had that overlapping for a while. Still did nothing. Let's see if we can shift this over just a little bit. Get it so that we're at least lining up a little. There we go. So that should do it. This will also allow us to skip passes now, which will make for easier turning. Definitely glad to be back to making videos. Just needed to take the time to sit down and get ahead again, so that way I'm not, you know, doing a video every night trying to rush and get it up like I was. That doesn't work. Back up even to skip a pass. This thing's got some terrible turning. Come on, line up. It's insane, the turning radius on this thing. Just how terrible it is. We're getting there though, with the sunflowers. We got all kinds of lights that come on this thing. Oh, I turned my graphics down, that's right. Turned them down for multiplayer, forgot to turn them back up. Multiplayer runs a little bit smoother on medium. So I turn them down to medium whenever I'm playing multiplayer. And then when I go back to single player, I'm on very high. I really like this combine though, it's pretty nice. It's a nice size. It's not too terribly large. The only difference is the combine that we'll start with will be the floater tire instead of the dual, I think. I don't know, I haven't decided yet. I'll have to decide on that. And of course we'll be starting with the Farm King auger, and then either the Brant or the Sakundaic. I don't know. The red Canadian auger. One of those two augers for unloading bins. And then, of course, we'll start with the smaller bins as well. So we'll have a nice lineup of equipment to start with on my map. Work our way up. Hope to start by the time you watch this video, I should have maybe one or two videos out of my map. So hopefully this upcoming mapping video will be adding farms. I still need to work on all the field stuff. There should be a video coming up soon, or else has already happened, of a drive around on my map to figure out field sizes and prices, doing all that stuff. But first there will be a video of the of setting up the fields. Because, like, you gotta set up all the field numbers and all that stuff, and then, you know, for my map, also having to set up the Century 21, get that thing going and whatnot. The only thing that I won't be doing with the Century 21 right now is adding the, is changing the image that's inside. That won't be done until the map's complete. And then I only have to do that part once, because I really don't want to have to do that part more than once, because it's, you know, going to be a long process. I mean, I could put the PDA map on there just to have like a general idea, but, you know, I won't have all of the other stuff that I want to have on there. So, not really the best idea to do right now. Thing even getting dirty yet? Doesn't look like it. I think I need to adjust the dirt duration on this stuff. make it a little bit faster. I was going to look. I think I cleaned this out. No, I did not. Because I was going to get rid of a couple of these combines. Like, probably this S98, because it's only good when you're running it. It's kind of a nuisance otherwise. I'm going to get rid of the S660. Get rid of some of these other combines too. This and this I'm not going to get rid of, I don't think, because they're kind of neat yet. But then also just need to get rid of some headers and stuff. Need to go through my mods again and clean up a bunch of stuff. I did go through quite a bit. But I also want to sit one day and get rid of, go through every single mod. You know, of course not going to do all of them in a day, but, you know, go through all the mods that I have and make them all error-free if I possibly can. And just make some changes, make some edits, redo some stuff maybe even, or get rid of it, you know, whatever I do. But just, you know, go through and make it error-free, hopefully. Get rid of all errors and everything, you know, if something doesn't work right, try and fix it and make it work right, or say whatever and get rid of it. So to do that, that would mean taking every single mod out of my mods folder, putting them in there in a separate folder, and then putting things back one at a time. Of course, things like probably soil mod and like drive control, those, you know, some of those scripts that I use, those will be fine. Okay, we're gonna go like this just because I wasn't paying attention. But we are going to try and make this a realistic way here. Make this work in a realistic way. Maybe. We'll see what happens here. But, yeah, like I was saying, you know, just try and get things error-free. Oh, yeah. It has to start up. I need to adjust the start sound on this thing because it's so long. I also need to adjust the indoor camera some, I think. Maybe, I don't know. I mean, it works for me. It's good enough for me, so. I guess I don't care too terribly much. So then this will fill this truck so we can take it to the bins. Can only go like a max of 25 miles an hour. But in real life you really can't drive that fast. You don't want to drive that fast across the field anyway, so. Otherwise, you might be hitting the roof a few times. So, I'll be able to take this back to the bins, unload it. We can have at least one load of sunflowers here. Maybe we'll get another load off of here. I'd have loved to have gotten a whole lot more than that, of course, but it does not look like that's going to happen, unfortunately. Okay. Now we can get out of here. Kind of slow going here, but the truck is kind of damaged as well. Might have to repair it. It just must just be the way that I'm looking at these tires. Whoa. I see the tires are starting to get dirty here. Let's see a little bit. I really do like the sounds on this thing. I'm glad that I found them on American Eagles. They are some nice sounds. Okay, so we're gonna pull the Oliver over. Pull the open station over here. We'll put this on there, I guess. Take these duals off of it. Whoa. Whoops. Kind of went through that a little bit. Ah, that's good enough. Run over here. That's a pretty good looking screenshot. Okay, so I think what I am going to do is I am going to end the video here. Just because, you know, I'm just going to make these like 20 minutes. Or something like that. I don't know what the deal is with that cylinder. I've tried all kinds of things with it and it still looks goofy. Whoa. But yeah, I think I'm just going to do like 20 minutes. Just because it's plenty long. And it... With this, we're doing the same thing over and over because it's kind of slow going right now. So, just to not be like completely repetitive, but I think what I'm going to do between now and the next video is combine a little bit more of the sunflowers, get it. So maybe I'm done with the first set of passes and then we're ready to do this second set. We'll see what happens here, I guess. See how far I get. And then go from there. But, yeah. So, that's what I'm going to do. That way, it, like I said, it's not quite so repetitive here. And, also because I just want to... Then I can also just work on some other videos, too. So yeah, and just kind of get us through this a little bit without taking ages. But yeah, so that's gonna do it. If you guys enjoyed the video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Be sure to subscribe if you like what you see. Be sure to turn on the post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. Be sure to check out down below in the description for my PC specs, my upload schedule, as well as links to all my social medias and some other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at. Thanks for watching, you guys. As always, we'll see you tomorrow.